Get out.
Hello, tankers and tankettes, and welcome to another of my replays. This one is the VK45.02A, which is the Tier 8. Sometimes people call it the duck tank, but it's not the duck tank. AMX-40 is the duck tank. Anyone calling anything else the duck tank should be, you know. Well, once I'm in charge of, well, everything, I'll have all those people rounded up and sent to re-education, camps, centres, because clearly they are sadly misinformed, and I will make it my life's work to correct their erroneous ways. Anyway, this is my ace tanker game, and this is kind of an odd heavy tank because it's not really a heavy tank. The armour will bounce things sometimes. It's better against same tier mediums and lower tier heavies. If you're fighting same tier heavies and above head to head, that's not a good place to be for the most part. Partly because of the armour, partly because of the gun is basically the middle gun on the Tiger II, so you don't even have as good, the armament isn't as good. And it's kind of, I find that kind of odd because, like, on the tank destroyer tree at tier 8, you've got the Ferdy and the Agpanther 2, one's got the mobility, one's got the armour-ish, but they've both got the same gun, basically. That's not the case with the two heavies, but maybe it's just they decided that this turret couldn't mount that gun? I don't know. It makes no sense to me. Anyway, Tiger 2, but he's stock, so he's probably sporting the same gun I am. Or maybe not. I'm not quite sure how it works with the Tiger 2 tech tree. Don't own one myself yet. Anyway, lower front plate of a Tiger 2, yes please. This is not an ideal place to be, but I'm a top tier heavy, so I kind of felt I had to go here. And it's going to be kind of a weird match, but it's going to work out quite well for me. I basically end up playing this like a medium, or, you know, or maybe more like an IS, something like that. Pop out, do some damage, pull back into cover. And there's bad things around the corner. There's a T-29, which is going to be hard to hurt. There's an ISU over there. The Tiger 2 I'm not too worried about, but the IS-3 is... KV-3, making a push for it. Well, you're stuck there, mate. And I can pull back, and you're just stuffed. Wahaha. Yep, low front plate. Or I could just track him again. I could have shot him there, actually. I'm not sure why I tracked him. But on the other hand, you know, that's assistance damage, which is always nice. So, yeah. You may notice the reticles aren't my usual reticles exactly, but the reticles in replays, even if it's 8.8, it still manages to be buggy. Not as buggy as the other ones, but it just doesn't remember your settings. Anyway. Oh, he didn't burn out. Oh. They won't let me play with matches anymore for some reason. Anyway, that's one less. I'm up to nearly 2k damage, actually. The penetration on this gun is okay. It's usable. It's not fantastic for a tier 8 heavy, but it's okay, especially when you get to hit sides or weakly armoured targets. You know, the alpha is more than sufficient. I'm just having a quick look. Yeah, I'm kind of isolated here. If they decide to push on me, all my support is now much further back. But on the other hand, I'm keeping these guys, well, not lit up, but proximity spotted in some cases. And I'm also kind of a bait, almost, because I'm here and... that's a rare bounce. I'm not quite sure where he shot me, but I managed to get one into him, which is always nice. And I've retained most of my hit points up till this stage, which is unusual for this tank in this situation. Because it does not tend to do that well. So this ISU, he's thinking about trying it again. I've still got backup. The rest of the map is 4-6. It's going okay. It's maybe a slight disadvantage, but it's not looking like this is going to be a complete rout. That snapshot was never going to work. But yeah, if we can clear out the valley of these heavies here, that can make it a lot easier to just in his tracks. That can make it a lot easier to then clear up the rest of the map, but it depends. But I know this isn't that popular map with some people, but I kind of like it because it's there's not that many different routes through the map, but it doesn't feel like there's a whole bunch of choke points exactly. This obviously is a choke point, but somehow the rest of the map, it doesn't really feel like it. But I like maps where there's like one ambiguous kind of really clear point that you have to take. Anyway, ISU, he's low health, but it could hurt. He's not looking at me though, so there we go. Pop out, finish him off. Just the T29 now. 9-9, we're a little kind of even. This T29's had it. And again in the track, so I'm thinking about going for the assistance damage with this particular match, which is always nice if you can manage it and people are actually hitting the tanks that you're tracking. So I've come through that with, you know, that's respectable, 3,000 damage. That's probably higher than my average for this tank because I have some decent games in it. Other games it just feels completely useless. It really depends on the rest of your team and what the enemy team's doing, and the map as well, of course. Now, there is an enemy lurver who was doing absolutely nothing for his team, so this guy is just free hit points for me, basically. And, yeah, he's not botting, he is actually there, he's just... Oh, I'm going to guess, when you're playing a lurver like that, I'm going to guess it's someone with, like, 2,000 or 3,000 battles that really doesn't know what they're doing in a higher tier match. You do tend to see, unfortunately, people who will buy... They'll see that they can buy a high-tier tank for actual money and they'll go, ooh! Even though it's not a particularly cheap investment. And it's just a waste of their money and everyone else's time, frankly. Anyway, in this particular situation, I'm not going to complain because it's free damage for me. And again, into his tracks. And let's see if I can whack his lower front plate or even the same place. So here we go, more damage. I've actually done more than 1k damage out of this one camping heavy tank. And there, nice, another kill. I've actually done quite a lot of damage. Sometimes it works out like that, you'll do loads of damage but don't do that many kills, and other times you'll have like 1,000 damage and 5 kills. Some matches are a bit... The kills are not the best indicator of how somebody's doing. But on the other hand, if you're doing loads of damage, but you're not killing anything, that means there's still lots of low health enemies, you know, driving around. And low health is good, but their guns still work just as well as if they had full health. So I basically want... normally I'd be shouting, you know, in this case, don't cap, but actually these guys are very useful bait. Because two of them on cap, yep. See, against a Hellcat, this armor can work quite well. There's the enemy VK. See, this is perfect. They are just charging at the guys on the cap, and I'm in a perfect position. Yep. This thing sometimes struggles to penetrate itself. So the armor is okay up to sometimes up to about 200 mil of pen, but not always. So there is two enemy tank destroyers left. I know the Hellcat's pretty low health. T25 is in a slower tank. If I was in my KV4, for instance, this kind of mobility closing up on these guys like this would not really be possible. Oh well, they killed that guy, so unfortunately I don't get to kill him. No top gun. And I could have at this point said, get out the cap, and gone after the A20 because there was enough time to get back, but. Meh. I just decided the win's the win, so yeah, I was happy with that. I ended up with quite a decent amount of damage. 5k damage is pretty good in any tier 8 tank. You know, maybe not the ISU is probably the easiest one to do that amount of damage in, but 5k damage in this tank, you know, and the amount of damage I actually took myself, I think I took like 2 hits, something like that. This was definitely one of my better matches, and I was kind of not surprised to see it was going to be, you know, when I got to the score screens and saw it was my Ace Tanker badge. But it was not only the 5k damage, it was actually the 2k assistance damage as well. That obviously had a big, that was a big factor in that Ace Tanker badge. On the whole, I like this tank-ish. It's very good in certain situations, but sometimes you'll get in a match and you're just thrust into, you're up against enemy heavies, higher tier enemy heavies, and there's nothing you can really do. I would actually almost like to use the long 88 on this, but it actually has a worse rate of fire than the Tiger these days, so it's not the best choice. If it had as good a rate of fire as the Tiger, it wouldn't even have to necessarily be better, just the same. Actually, it would be a really good, there would be a really good choice of guns on this, because you could have the punchier high alpha gun, lower reload, lower accuracy, or you could have the long 88, which has same penetration, better accuracy, better rate of fire. So, you know, you can see why I'd go for that gun, because I like those kind of choices on a tank. Anyway, yeah, Ace Tanker, that's not bad. I'm going to go for a mouse, you guys. I want a mouse. Mouse. I'll get there eventually. In the meantime, this isn't a terrible grind for the Tier 8. The Tier 9 promises to be a bit more so. I know that thing has a bit of a reputation, but this is okay. I think it just doesn't compare favourably to the Tiger 2, because the Tiger 2 is such a good machine. But if you're looking at it in its own merits, it's more like something along the lines of the Tiger or the AMX M4, but at Tier 8. The FCM 50T is probably the best comparison I can make for Tier 8. It's not quite the same machine, but it's not far off that playstyle. Anyway, if you enjoyed this video, you can leave a comment, you can hit the like button, you can subscribe to my channel, and of course, as always, stay tuned for more.